Hey everybody, this is April with April Miller Coaching, and I'm doing the second part of this series on sugar. And today I'm going to be talking with you my commitment to a sugar detox. I'm going to be explaining my why and my stories around sugar, and I just hope you find it valuable with your own life. You may find some things that are similar. You may, want to go ahead and go on board with me. By detoxing or even just reducing your sugar consumption. But if you're anything like me, you know that sugar tastes wonderful and you totally feel like you have to have it all the time. So I've always liked sugar. Last blog we talked about how we're kind of inborn with that taste bud. But I was really introduced to sugar as a child, meaning candy and desserts, at a very young age. And even though my mom was totally against it because she knew the bad things that could happen with sugar. But my dad, he loved candy, he loved desserts, and he figured it would be okay, it's no big deal. But what happened was some things that led into my adult life. So the first thing that happened was I had 8 cavities at 13 years old. Very painful. And I know you don't get cavities when you don't brush, and that's easy to just say that and to think that and to blame yourself and to blame others. Well, they just have cavities because they don't brush their teeth, but that's not always true. I blame myself all the time until I got some additional information regarding that as I grew up and talked to my dentist and did some research and things like that. Because I realized that if my sugar consumption was way down, that probably wouldn't have happened, especially with the 8 cavities. It's a very strong substance, sugar is, and it can just tear through those teeth and just sit there for a long time. It's very, just sticky on your teeth. I understand carrots can cause cavities too, or lettuce, or whatever you want to name that's healthy, a healthy food. But it's mainly because those get stuck in between our teeth and we don't floss. And yes, I've been guilty of not flossing as well. But the sugar will sit there. And I know that back then it was all because of sugar. So not only did I have to suffer through all those cavities getting filled, but I also put on weight. And it was harder to get off when I got older because I was always in the habit of eating sugar and dessert. Take a moment and think about yourself right now. What's hardest to give up? Is it carbs? Is it sugar? Is it both? Carbs and sugar kind of go hand in hand because they work together as far as making carbs. But anyways, so most of you know, if you are friends with me on Facebook or follow me on Instagram or Twitter or on my Facebook page of April Miller Coaching, that there's been a lot of things going on in my life. And those that know me, I know, what's new? But it's some pretty major things that have happened. So for those that don't know, I got engaged in March of 2017. I began planning for a wedding immediately. By the way, it's in 2 days as I'm doing this video. We got in the process of buying our first home. You can kind of see it in the background. I moved out of my home. I moved into his temporarily. Then I moved everything to our first home. And then there's lots of little stuff in between. I moved classrooms or schools. So I had to move all my stuff from my old classroom to my new classroom and unpack it. And so what do you do when you're busy a lot and you're moving? You eat out. We did a lot of that. And I am just very, very sick of eating out. I'm just done. But I got back into that habit of eating sugar and dessert because when you're on the go and you forgot to pack a snack and you haven't planned things out, you grab something convenient, and it's mainly carbs and sugar. My fiance and I had made an agreement to focus on ourselves so we could be in our best shape by the wedding. Well, remembering what I just said, it's very hard to do because we gave into temptation a lot. But last week, after being kind of semi-settled down, I decided that I was sick of this, and I got mad and I got angry with myself on the inside, and I said, I am going to let this emotion just take its course and I'm going to respond to it. And I used that to really drive myself into committing to be on a sugar detox. And that's okay to do with yourself. You need to get mad at yourself. You need to get angry with yourself when you're trying to change something in your life, and just go for it. And I remembered that when I had this same emotion in February of 2016, that's when I committed to being healthy and dropping the weight and getting into a fitness routine and being on my health journey. And while I'm still on my health journey, I know that I can go back and be more dedicated to it. My goal for myself, and I don't encourage you to do a food goal for yourself, but it's reality. My food goal is to have a piece of wedding cake on Saturday if I go sugar-free all the way through to the wedding. So I think it was like 9 days, and I'm like, oh my gosh, can I do it? Can I actually have that self-control to ignore things and say no? Because I went back to those temptations and I've been having just junk. But I knew that I had done this before, so why can't I do it again? I'm in control of myself. I'm my own leader. I'm my own boss. So why can't I? So my next blog, or my next video, I will tell you what happened with my self-control, especially when this temptation has been all over the place. Any type of environment you can think of, there's sugar. And I'm going to divulge to you exactly what has happened over these days. I do have 2 days to go as of this blog, so the next blog I do, I will have, it will be a complete sugar detox, and I will let you know if I was able to go all the way through with that complete sugar detox, or if I had temptation, or if I slipped. And so I will let you know of that on my next blog, so and video. So the link below is to the blog if you wish to read the transcript. Please share with me your biggest challenge this summer, and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.